Drug Addicts. I'm the Frank Friar. Let's get frank about it. Hello, Carmelos. I invite you, if you haven't yet, to make sure you subscribe to the channel and give the video a like. These things really do help other people find me in the YouTube algorithm. But I also invite you to leave a comment down below letting me know how you're dealing with drug-related issues in your life, or if there's someone in your family that has a drug addiction, and etc. Maybe we can help each other out in the comments section today. Thank you again. All right, Carmelos, I've received several messages through starting this whole social media ministry related to or on the topic of drug addiction. I'm also from rural Michigan. The opioid crisis is hammering my home area pretty hard and has impacted people that are close to me and etc. And one of the things I get asked regularly is, Father, what am I to do? You know, usually someone tells me about a family member or someone that's struggling in their life with a variety of addiction issues. My own background is I've dealt with a lot of people with alcohol-related issues and et cetera. And, you know, I just, usually when they come to me and they talk to me, they're either at the beginning of a crisis or they're at the moment of sheer exhaustion. They just are done. They're worn out. They don't know what to do, but yet they're Christian people and they want to care. They want to love, and they're just exhausted beyond belief. And you know, I just invite them into prayer, and I sit with them, and I listen to them, because one of the things I think that are going on is we have a real fix-it culture where we always got to do something. We got to do. And you know, a lot of times maybe people just need to be listened to and heard, so they can become open to the gifts and the strengths that lie inside of them. But I remind them that, you know, forgiveness and forgetting are not the same thing. You know, we're called to forgive the people in our lives, to let Christ's grace free our hearts from these burdens that weigh us down. But that doesn't mean we forget what they've done. That doesn't mean we forget how dangerous they could be in the fits of a drug addiction and etc. And, you know, our charity should never be a source of enabling, of, you know, allowing someone to sort of spin out of control, you know, because we always have to discern how it is that we're being charitable. Are we using our charity as a way of controlling the other, you know, even in the fits of a drug addiction, and whatever that drug addiction may be, you know, whether it may be with drugs, and it could be other things too, you know, pornography, video games, shoplifting, etc. You know, the addictive behavior knows no bounds. But, you know, what is really charitable in that moment? When I walk around New York City, I usually carry, for example, food and a bottle of water or two on me. I never really carry money when a homeless person, you know, usually, you know, red in the face, leathery skin, somewhat bloated, reeking of gin or some other sort of alcohol, wants money from me. I have a general idea of what they're going to use for it. And I said, well, you know, I don't have money to give. And they're like, Father, Jesus said one. And I said, oh, be careful before you quote the scriptures with me. I said, what did Jesus say? Matthew chapter 25, the parable of the sheep and the goats. He said, when I was hungry, you gave me food. When I was thirsty, you gave me drink, and I offered the person food and water. And if they rejected, they rejected. They accepted, they accepted. So, you know, dealing with a drug addict, reach out there and get help. Don't be ashamed of seeking help, of seeking support in your life, of seeking people that will listen to you, to give you the tools necessary to deal. And one of the things, because drug addiction impacts us on the whole level of the person, you know, the person that's a drug addict, you know, there's the physical dimension, there's the psychological, the behavioral, the emotional, and the spiritual. You know, for those that are around them that are dealing with sort of the wake of their loved one's drug addiction, you know, we're all dealing with those realities too. And in relationship to the charitable aspect, the spiritual aspect, we need to be aware of what would true charity, true Christian charity be in regards to that person's unique situation. So there's no definitive answer. You know, you can keep pouring money and money down the situation, and they just keep going down and down deeper into the addiction. You know, and then there's the, some people believe in the whole cutting them off completely, you know, and if you don't do certain things, we have no contact. And I'm not a psychologist, I'm not going to get into that approach, whether it works or not. But what I'm saying is, it's a call. It's a call for discerning one's charity in the light of the situation that you're in, and to never put yourself in a situation where you could be physically harmed, even by somebody that loves you. They may still love you, but they're in the chains of the addiction, and their pattern of behavior at that time can push somebody to extremely dangerous actions. So my brothers and sisters, you know, I'm going to make sure in the comment section down below to put some groups that you can reach out to maybe get information for to empower your life. But also remember that somebody in your life going through a drug addiction, that doesn't necessarily mean, you know, particularly if you're a parent, et cetera, that, you know, you've done something necessarily wrong. But your child, your friend, your family, they have made choices in their life, you know, and the biological component that drives certain people to addictions, you know, we need to own our behaviors and we need to own our mistakes as part of the healing process. That's why the 12-step process is so important in realizing that you're powerless against your addiction, the very first thing. So, you know, in a way, we have to realize that we're ourselves are powerless over the ability to control our loved ones in the fit of their addictions. And always in the prayerful process, you know, instead of, you know, keep praying for deliverance and praying for healing, but also pray for discernment, pray how to act. What can I do right now, Lord? How are you calling me to be charitable to this person? What can I do to keep myself safe? And seek the necessary help. One of the great things about the electronic era is all this sort of information is just a click of the mouse away. So my brothers and sisters, know that I'm with you. Know that I'm with you. May our Lord continue to aid you all as you care for those in the midst of drug addiction, or if you're in a drug addiction moment in your life too, know that our Lord looks on you with such loving eyes, and know that his peace is only one word away, and that's yes, yes to his presence in your life. Thank you, my brothers and sisters, again for your time. Know that I'll be praying for you in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hey, Carmelos, if you liked today's video, please make sure to leave a comment down below. Maybe we can get a good conversation going and help people through the comment section on how they can get the necessary strength in their life to aid those that are dealing with drug addiction, or for those that are in the middle of a drug addiction themselves, too. Also, if you haven't yet, please subscribe to the channel. It really does help me, and give the video a like. Thanks again. Thank you.